Right, Shalom to the elect of Israel. First, I want to give all praises to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, Wahara Kakwadash. Double honors to the apostles of Great Millstone that taught us this truth. Right, this video I'm going to be speaking about, it's going to be kind of a, you know, an open topic, you know, because, you know, Lord willing, I'm just going to go in the spirit with this one, because I'm just thinking of a topic to speak on. But I mean, the first scripture that I was thinking about that I wanted to talk on was the scriptures in Malachi, the fourth chapter, where it speaks about the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. All right. And that's the day that's going to come, man, when these missiles that these nations have. Right, the intercontinental ballistic missiles, the nuclear weapons that they have, they're going to be used. Right, that those missiles are going to be used, and those high temperatures, the you know, the nuclear warheads, and the fire and brimstone is going to be used to destroy, namely America, right, which is Babylon the Great. You know, that is the judgment for that land, for that nation, okay, because that nation is spearheading the wickedness that is going on in the world, man, you know, spreading this wine, which is this philosophy, you know, it's that's being spread throughout the world, man, because when you think about it, a lot of American culture and, TV, media, that's broadcasted all over the world. You know, that's what they call popular culture. You know, you'll have American music playing in Zimbabwe. You have American music playing in India, in New Zealand, or, you know, Europe, all over the world. You know? So, you know, and, you know, you got that term Americanization. You know, you got a lot of these countries that follow the influence of America, you know. So, America is spearheading a lot of the degenerates and the wickedness that we see in this world, man. The alphabet groups, you know, the, you know, the divorce rates, you know, and, you know, all that wickedness, man. And that's a major reason why the Lord is going to bring that judgment. Okay, in Malachi, the fourth chapter, which I quoted. All right, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven. You know, and all the proud, yeah, and all that do wickedly shall be stubble. You know, which shall leave them neither root nor branch. All right, roughly quoting. That day is coming, man. That day when the Lord is going to bring that fiery judgment. All right. And these lands that are going to get hit as well. A lot of these lands are going to get hit with these ICBM missiles. Okay. That's going to be the result of World War III, which is prophesied in the Bible, man. All right. Isaiah 9:5, you know, it says, you know, that the battle of the warrior is with confused noise, you know, and garments rolled in blood, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. All right. So what's that? What does that mean? That, you know, because in the ancient world, you know, in the past, you would have men go to battle and war with swords and shields. You know, they would have armies of men charging and roaring at each other and thrusting each other through with the sword. But in these last days, what's going to be, you know, the weapons that they're going to use? That's going to be the ICBM missiles, man. You know, that's the judgment the Lord sees fit, because, hey, that's what's known in the scriptures as the second death. The second death that's coming is when these nuclear missiles are used to destroy America, man. Nuclear warfare. And a lot of these people, they're going to be burnt up in those countries. You know, because you got to think about it, man. When these, you know, nuclear missiles happen, when they drop, they're not going to give nobody chance notice to leave the country, you know. At best, you might get an announcement 15 minutes, 10 minutes before, at best, if you're lucky. But that's useless because a lot of these missiles can reach over different continents in less than 15, 30 minutes. The scripture says Babylon shall be destroyed within 1 hour. Revelations 18, America, Babylon the Great, you know, shall be destroyed within 1 hour, man. What can do that? That's these ICBM missiles, you know, which all these nations are perfecting. They're testing, especially Russia. Putin, you know, is firing his missiles, you know, doing those tests. You know, and you know, they're gonna be the, you know, Russia and America is gonna be the main superpowers that's gonna be fighting this third world war, man. And it's really no joke. It's going to be a time of great tribulation because leading up to it, before World War III can take place, there has to be the mandatory mark, all right? Revelations 13 and 16, the RFID, okay? That kerygma, that's going to be made mandatory for the whole world. All people are going to be put through the hour of temptation where they will be tried, man. Their faith will be tested. Whether they're gonna bow and serve the devil, Esau, the so-called white man and his NWO system, or you know, are you gonna serve the Lord, man? Which the elect, they're gonna reject that chip and they're gonna serve the Lord, man. Even if it means losing their lives for faith in the Lord, which really they don't lose salvation because the scriptures tell you that the dead shall rise first in the Lord. And they shall be caught up together to meet the Lord in the air, in the clouds, man. All right, because that's the only way we're going to get out of this destruction. The select few Israelites, the men of the Lord, the elect, you know, those that are chosen to be saved from the destruction of World War III, they're going to be beamed up into those chariots, all right, the ships, the so-called UFOs. The holy angels are going to bear them up, you know, and deliver them. And that's where we want to be. That's why we do this work. That's why we preach the gospel. You know, because the scriptures tell you that he that endures unto the end, the same shall be saved. So we got to be going through tribulation, temptations, a lot of things, man, before salvation, before the end can come. You know, and the ultimate end is going to be those missiles, man. Okay, that's just what I had on my mind. I was thinking about Malachi, the fourth chapter. You know, the day cometh that shall burn as an oven, and that day is going to come, man. You know, it's when you hear this truth, you know, just speaking for myself, you know, a lot of, you know, when I came and first heard this truth in the early days, man, I remember seeing. You know, the brothers in the camp with the America being destroyed, you know, according to God, you know, that sign. We had a sign, we had a poster, a sign, big sign, man, you know, of a big mushroom cloud and written America will be destroyed according to God, man, you know. And that really puts, you know, that for me, that put fear in me, man, because and it's like I knew it, I felt, I believed it to be true. You know, and it's just one of those things. It's like, you know, the Lord opened your mind to this, man, and this is gonna happen. You know, there's a reason that you see a lot of these movies, I mean, these blockbuster films, they depict America being destroyed by fire. That's no coincidence. So a lot of these people, and you're gonna have 2/3 of our people, all right, 2/3 of the Israelites, they're gonna be caught in that destruction. The Lord is gonna leave them there in that land to be burned alive, man. Now, why is that? What's the reason? Because they don't repent. They remain rebellious. They continue to not listen to the Lord, man. They don't take heed to the word. They don't hearken unto the word of the prophets. All right, and we're preaching of this day. We're prophesying the downfall of these heathens, of these nations, the ones that put us in slavery. All right, especially that harsh, chattel slavery, that dark history of America. The Lord hasn't forgotten about that. So that's why the Lord has this judgment prepared for that land, for America. And those of our people that don't get right, those of our people that want to continue worshiping idols, worshiping the false image of the so-called white man Jesus, all right, which that's not his name and that's not his image. But our people that are hard-headed, can't get this truth, want to keep being wicked, they're going to be left in that fire, man. They're going to be destroyed in that land. All right, those that love their oppressors, they ain't going to make it. The Lord's not going to deliver them. They're going to have to come through on the other side after their fiery destruction. So this is why we want to get this truth on this round, man. We want to endure and do what we can and please the Lord that he will in favor deliver us, man. Right? Because trust, man, we trust and believe we don't want no part in that fiery destruction, man. In that lake, that the lake of fire, right, that America's gonna be turned into. All right, we don't want no part of that. Lord willing, man, that's where we'll be delivered. The brothers over actually in Babylon, we're praying for the Archon that we want to see brothers make it, man. And the lands where we've been scattered, we want to be delivered, man, because this is the end. We're in the last days, man. So now's the time to repent, return unto the Lord through this truth while there's still time, man. So I'm going to end it there. Lord willing, it was edifying. I just had some thoughts and I just wanted to make a lesson. Lord willing, it was edifying. And I want to say all praises to Yahweh, Baal Shem, Yahweh Shai, Wahara Kakwadash, the bonus to the apostles. All right. Salutes to Yakim teaching this truth to the elect in truth and sincerity. All right. To the elect, Shalom.